Hey, you all. Carpetbagger here, coming to you live from the south, more specifically Little Rock, Arkansas. And even more specifically than that, I'm in front of the Bill Clinton Presidential Library. Of course, Little Rock, the home of Bill Clinton during his time as governor of Arkansas. So we're gonna go visit the Presidential Library of Bill Clinton, learn a little bit about the history of the man himself today. Also, they have an exhibit on the 1990s, which should be interesting. And Bill Clinton, of course, the most 90s president of all time. So very, very appropriate as well. So please, follow me. Now the building sits here right on the banks of the Arkansas River. The building itself is meant to look like a bridge to match with Bill Clinton's catchphrase that he is building a bridge to the 21st century. It's a little different from some of the other presidential libraries. The Oval Office here, they don't now allow you to take photos or video inside, basically just so they can take their own photo and sell it to you for $15. Okay, walking along bridge-like structure, definitely an interesting design to this building, much different than a lot of the other presidential libraries that I've visited. A very interesting design, and you can see that these pillars here actually contain boxes of archives. So they have like their archives out here where you can view them, which is interesting because, you know, a presidential library is supposed to be where archives are kept. I was just saying there's a tradition in Maine that the first salmon taken out of the Pembasket River is sent to the president. Unfortunately, someone accidentally ate the salmon, so they had to send the president a fishing lure instead. Whoops, ate the president's salmon. There's a Bill Clinton marching band doll. Of course, he was in marching band growing up, famously playing the saxophone. This case contains gifts that was given to the president during his presidency. Here's a presidential quilt given to Bill by an adoption agency in Kansas. And here's an original seat from Wrigley Field donated to the president. And look at this, a big piece of Chihuly glass in the middle of the museum here. It says that during all 8 years of Clinton's presidency, they had a different theme for Christmas. And these are all different Christmas ornaments that was used in the White House. It's like a slipper right there and a tiny little suit. This is interesting. It's like a Native American figure holding a cow skull. Oh, look, it's the Roosevelts. Look, there's Socks the Cat. Here's Hillary Clinton's collection of painted eggs. There's a tradition started from the White House Easter egg hunt. And over here we have these eggs that all have presidential heads painted on them. There's a painting of First Lady Hillary Clinton. These are all saxophones that were gifted to Bill. An avid saxophone player, of course.
Told me, life is like a regional healthcare alliance. If you pool your risks with a community health purchasing cooperative and mix in a prospective payment review, you can reach an ideal cost containment ratio while leaving the single payer system available. Now that's good advice.
What am I watching? There's a painting of the famous White House cat Socks. There's a sculpture, Bill Clinton with his beloved dog Buddy. And then there is Socks the Cat's food and water dish. Yeah, a lot of these presidential museums, you'll see that the presidents often receive presents from other countries, other foreign leaders. You see, Bill Clinton had his own collection of swords and daggers and ivory axes. It's a gown worn by Hillary. Here at the end of the hallway, you can see how the bridge shape building actually comes here to the edge of the water. And you can see a real bridge right there. That's a pedestrian footbridge right there. I guess it's an old railroad trestle turned into a pedestrian footbridge. Here's their temporary exhibit on the 90s. Said, like it's 1999. Oh, that's a reference to a song by Prince. We're going to party dot 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 like it's 1999. We have some remnants of the Berlin Wall, along with some George H.W. Bush and Mikhail Gorbachev suspenders. Here's a commemorative watch for the Persian Gulf War. There is some cologne inspired by Norman Schwarzkopf called Desert Storm V Norman. That's interesting. There's a paperweight and ribbon commemorating the Oklahoma City bombing. You got Princess Di and Beanie Babies. And then who could forget the Y2K bug? Y2K were on it, and then I guess that is supposed to represent the Y2K bug itself. Some comics and books from the 90s, Calvin and Hobbes, Harry Potter, Goosebumps, Babysitter Club. Some examples of 90s fashion. We have the grunge movement over here, the ripped jeans, flannel shirt, Pearl Jam t-shirt underneath, and then this beautiful purple Reebok tracksuit. We have a hair clip, scrunchies, and then one of those necklace thingies that girls used to wear in the 90s. Okay, now we're talking. This is pretty amazing. This is Forrest Gump's running gear. This was actually worn by Tom Hanks while filming Forrest Gump. Oh, that's pretty crazy. See the Bubba Gump hat and those iconic shoes. And then this is a flannel and t-shirt worn by Garth in Wayne's World. Of course, Titanic was huge, one of the biggest movies of the 90s. There is a period outfit worn by Kate Winslet. And then this note here was used in the movie. It says, make it count, meet me at the clock. A baseball uniform from League of Their Own. You know, there's no crying in baseball and all that. Here's some screen-used miniatures from Independence Day. I guess this is an alien spacecraft. And then there's one of the aliens. But look at this. These are like little tiny office supplies that must have been used in some scene. It's been a long time since I've seen it, but apparently there was a apparently miniature office scene. Maybe it was an office being blown up or something. Okay, these movie artifacts are pretty good here. I can't argue with that. This is John Hammond's cane from Jurassic Park with the mosquito there stuck in the amber at the end. That is an incredibly iconic piece of film right there. This collection of 90s movies props is pretty amazing. This is Men in Black props. This is a little tiny gun used by Will Smith. And then one of those things that make people forget, where he would hold it up and click it into their eyes. Both used in the movie. That's so cool. Robin Williams' Mrs. Doubtfire dress. Tom Hanks is well represented here because this space helmet was worn by Tom Hanks in Apollo 13. Here we have the television section. There's the Beavis and Butthead, an iconic duo in the 90s. There's an animation frame from The Simpsons. Simpsons will always be, you know, one of my favorite shows of all time and one of my biggest comedic inspirations. There's these screen-used FBI badges for Mulder and Scully from X-Files. And then an actual wooden stake used by Buffy the Vampire Slayer, Sarah Michelle Gellar. Okay, now this is pretty funny. In the Bill Clinton Library, that is the original Ass Man license plate from the Seinfeld episode. And I have mixed feelings about Seinfeld in retrospect, some of the messages that were portrayed, but I do remember that episode. Kramer accidentally got a license plate that was supposed to go to a proctologist, but he couldn't get it changed out, and then he learned to embrace the name Ass Man. Yeah, 90s were a strange time back when we ate Urkel hosts. A Walker Texas Ranger t-shirt and hat given to Bill Clinton. I'm sure he wore them all the time. I think everyone that grew up in the 90s, like myself, can have some fond memories on this. Remember having to haul around all your CDs. I had like 3 of these giant CD books floating around my car. And even though they're all full of CDs, I still managed to scratch all my CDs and they wouldn't play. Into the music section, we have the Dixie Chicks. We have a shirt and hat worn by Garth Brooks. This outfit right here, this is worn by Britney Spears. And I can see she's a pretty tiny lady. This big puffy, shiny suit, this jumpsuit was worn by Sean Puffy Puff Daddy Combs in his Mo Money, Mo Problems video. This is one of the Notorious B.I.G.'s button-up shirts. Here we have technology, like it's 1999. Look at that big beefy laptop there. I don't know, did other people grew up in the 90s? Do you remember when you realized that computers no longer had these disk drives? These were called floppy disks. And I remember, they weren't floppy. Previous to this, they did have computer disks that were floppy, but then they made them smaller, and they kept calling them floppy. These are hard disks, but they always called it a floppy drive. It never made any sense to me. Of course, back in the 90s, early 2000s, you would get about 8,000 America Online CDs every day in your mailbox. Literally, there wasn't any room for any other mail because America Online would just continually send you CDs. Does anyone remember when Yellow Pages were this big, or big, enormous Yellow Pages that you had to paw through to find phone numbers? They still make these. I think they just all end up in dumpsters now. Yeah, it's just amazing to think before we had cell phones, the crappy methods of communication. We used the pager. The pager. I wonder if you can still get pager service. I was actually using a pager less than 10 years ago for work, and I couldn't believe that they still existed. And there's the Palm Pilot. It's basically a iPhone that was not a phone and that you couldn't play games on. It was basically a notepad, an electronic notepad. And the wonderful bag phone, because you know, you had to carry this massive thing around in a bag. Some 90s cameras. Of course, a lot of people in the 90s used those disposable cameras. They didn't take very good pictures. Oh man, I really wish I would have saved my Blockbuster membership card. This Discman CD player. I remember my mom got me one of these for my birthday, and it was expensive. Like, it cost quite a bit of money, and she had to buy like a more expensive version because if you wanted to listen to it in your car, you had to get the skip-resistant one. Otherwise, just the bumps in the car would make it unlistenable. So you had to get that special one that like had a delay on it so that it could skip the bumps of your car. Things used to be so complicated. Here's what I spent the majority of the 90s doing, playing Sega Genesis and Super Nintendo. And there's the Game Boy. The Game Boy, probably the longest lasting video game system of all time. They had the longest life. It's a PlayStation with Final Fantasy VII. I was so excited when Final Fantasy VII came out because I love Final Fantasy VI. And honestly, I know like some people cherish this game, but I find it tremendously disappointing. Oh, all the dumb stuff that we played with in the 90s. Koosh balls, pogs, hacky sacks. Here's a super soaker gifted to President Bill Clinton by the inventor. Doesn't look like he ever even took it out of the box. Yeah, more inexplicable stuff. Remember Beanie Babies? They had this bizarre like black market where they were worth like thousands of dollars. I wonder, does anyone know out there, do Beanie Babies, are they still worth anything, or are they just stuffed animals now? Troll dolls are kind of something that's every generation has had. I think they were popular in the 90s, but I think every generation has their own version of the troll doll.
Tickle Me Elmo, one of the most popular toys of all time. For a small time in the 1990s, one Christmas, it was literally the most sought after item in the United States. If you were given the choice between a sack of diamonds and a Tickle Me Elmo, you would take the Tickle Me Elmo, no questions asked. The Furby, the little toy that could actually learn how to speak, and it was banned by TSA because they were afraid that it would, learn secrets and pass them on. It's kind of creepy if you think about it. Pokemon cards. Now that's a fad that just literally never died. I think maybe the longest lasting fad of all time. Is that like a Tamagotchi right there? Where you had to like take care of an animal, clean up the poop, give them food. Basically it was like taking care of a pet without any of the benefits of having a pet. There's a table where you can play Pogs. I've literally never played Pogs. Even though I lived through the 90s. Let's see, they have the rules here. Okay, so you're supposed to stack these caps. I don't know how big of a stack you're supposed to have. Okay, let's get them stacked. Then you throw this at them called the Slammer. That wasn't very good. Let me try. There we go. And then any of them that land face up, you get to keep. Oh, okay, I get to keep this, the Mars rover. Apparently that's the, whoever has the most at the end of the game wins. This is not a good game. I think it was mostly about collecting different Pogs. This game does not seem very fun at all. What's this here? It's Light Cats and Dogs. It's an arcade machine with generic Super Nintendo controllers. Oh my gosh, it's a fighting game where you're fighting as robot versions of Sox and Buddy, Clinton's dog. What is this, some sort of bizarre apocalyptic scenario? Here we have a mock-up of Bill Clinton's cabinet room. There's a saxophone that was actually played by Bill Clinton at his own inauguration. Down here we see a little bit of humble bragging, talking about how things were before Clinton to how they were after Clinton. See, employment was up. Crime was down. Education went up. AIDS went down. Ooh, way down. Poverty went down. Technology was up. Health was up a tiny bit. See the restoring the economy. You can see the line going up there. I feel like there's gonna be some political debates in the comment section. Let's not do that. Let's just talk about how much fun we're having here at the Clinton Library. Here's some of the awards given to Hillary Clinton. She has a lot of awards. That's a Grammy right there. She has a Grammy. Here's some Russian nesting dolls. We see Bill Clinton is the largest out of the nest. And then we move on to George H.W. Bush, Boris Yeltsin, Mikhail Gorbachev, Helmut Kohl, John Major, Margaret Thatcher, Francois Mitterrand, and little tiny Saddam Hussein right there. There's a chess game that actually allows you to play out the conflict in Ireland. I don't know, that seems pretty intense. Talking about preparing for new military threats, there's models of some drones. We definitely have made use of those in the years following Clinton. Some drawings by school children sent to Bill Clinton on his birthday. You are a great president. Bill Clinton is special because he helps people. Different artworks. Some of them have different kinds of interpretations of what Clinton actually looked like. Although this one's probably the best. He is playing a saxophone with Socks the Cat popping out of the front. Some various political campaign materials. Look at that crazy hat right there. We have President Clinton's little limousine out here. Got some Bill Clinton merch here. Of course, Socks the Cat, a very popular character here. And then have a little bobblehead Bill right there. There we go. Rosebud. So that was the Bill Clinton Presidential Library. I always like to check out these presidential libraries. To me, you know, it's not about politics. It's about history and being able to see how history is represented there and you can maybe learn a little something. I just appreciate you guys joining me here at the Clinton Library. Definitely enjoyed the amazing 90s exhibit they had. That was really, really cool. If you'd like to see other places that I've been, please check the interactive map in the description of this video. You see all the different places I've been, and you can tell me where I need to go next. Also, if you'd like to help support the channel, consider buying a t-shirt. Consider donating to Patreon. A $3 more donation will get you a postcard once a month. I'm also now selling Smash Pennies in the Etsy shop. But until next time, this one's in the bag.